New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio says the federal government isn't doing enough. He says his city is preparing for the worst.
Already, our public health officials have distributed 1.5 million masks in the city of New York. That is a very good start, but we need more. We have requests out for an additional minimum of 300,000 surgical masks. To guarantee that these arrive in New York City promptly, we will need federal assistance.
Five new countries today reported their first cases. A U.S. soldier in South Korea has the coronavirus. More from correspondent Barbara Starr at the Pentagon.
This is a 23-year-old male Army soldier. He is now in a negative pressure isolation chamber, something that will help prevent cross-infection, where he is being treated in South Korea. 15 additional members in self-quarantine.
President Trump and top health officials are now planning to provide an update on the coronavirus for the nation at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. On Wall Street, the Dow finished down 123, S&P down 11. I'm Mike Moss.
If this were just any door, and this were just any ignition, connected to just any transmission, in just any vehicle, then perhaps it would be okay to buy it from just anyone. But this is not just any car. It's a certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz. Every detail has been inspected and road tested by highly skilled Mercedes-Benz technicians. And it's all backed by an unlimited mileage warranty, which makes the decision of where to buy one simple. Your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer. The certified pre-owned sales event going on now through March 7th. Come in today and enjoy a credit of up to $1,500 towards your first two payments through Mercedes-Benz Financial Services. Because in the end, it's absolute confidence in genuine Mercedes-Benz parts, or it isn't. It's either Mercedes-Benz certified pre-owned, or it isn't.
See your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer for complete details and limitations on credit towards your first 2 months payment and certified pre-owned warranties.
The Florida Strawberry Festival 2020. Our perfect vision for music and family fun. February 27th through March 8th. Oak Ridge Boys, Rascal Flatts, Tommy James and the Shondells, Michael Ray, Roots and Boots with Aaron Tippin, Sammy Kershaw and Colin Ray, 98 Degrees, Bobby Bones and the Raging Idiots, Reba McEntire, Neil McCoy, Patti LaBelle, Sarah Evans, Skillet, Chubby Checker, Josh Turner, The Golden Boys with Frankie Avalon, Fabian and Bobby Rydell, Mercy Me, Jimmy Fortune with Daly and Vincent, Darcy Lynn and Friends Live, Charlie Wilson, Eli Young Band, Leonard Skinner, and more on the Wish Farm Soundstage. Advance tickets are on sale now at flstrawberryfestival.com. That's flstrawberryfestival.com. The Florida Strawberry Festival 2020. Our perfect vision.
Thursday nights on WTAN from 10 p.m. to midnight, join Pastor Jeff Lane for live Bible teachings and call in prayer with Call to Pray. Former host of a syndicated TV show on CTN and pastor of Carpenter's Way Church in Dunedin. For more information about Pastor Jeff, Carpenter's Way Church, and how to watch Call to Pray Monday through Friday night, visit our website at PastorJeffLane.com and be sure to tune in to Call to Pray Live Thursday night from 10 p.m. to midnight and call in with your prayer needs right here on WTAN.
Viking encampment, pit of misery, escape room, all at the Bay Area Renaissance Festival. Weekend, February 15th through March 29th. Discount tickets are available at Circle K and online at BayAreaRenFest.com. Wiener dog races and high-flying duck dogs. Pet entertainment. Check out the all-new escape room. Bring your furry friends to the Bay Area Renaissance Festival this weekend for the Pirate and Pup Festival. Discount tickets available at Circle K and at BayAreaRenFest.com. Don't do it.
There's a new show on Tan Talk 1340. It's IMHO.love. That's In My Humble Opinion.love. Featuring me, comedian Lou Angel Wolf, and comedian Chris Gorgeous, Beth Snyder, who is our staff hypnotherapist, and of course our teacher into the XO consciousness, Michael Merberg.
Yes, we believe that the greatest wisdom is kindness and love unites us all.
Amen. And there's a bit of profundity every week at 7:30 on Tan Talk.
Go yard is a metaphor used in baseball, meaning to hit a home run. Life struggles can make you feel like you just struck out. It's times like these that we need a little batting practice to pick ourselves back up and get back in the game. Whether you are dealing with marital issues, drug addiction, rebellious teens, anxiety, depression, or just generally having a bad day, call Mama Mac. If life has you down 0-2, Before you strike out, learn to go yard. Go yard with Mama Mac on this radio station, Thursdays, 6 o'clock.
This is the Tantalk Radio Network.
Initialize sequence now.
Join the countdown. For actors, modeling, singers, songwriters, musicians, dancers, performers, and voiceovers from across the nation to across the world. Here with Dawn Reese on Hollywood Connections on Tantalk Radio 106.1 FM.
Hey, this is Vern Troyer, and you're listening to Dawn Reese's Hollywood Connections.
Hey, what up, you guys? It's your girl, Vivica Fox. You are watching Hollywood Connections on Tan Talk Radio with Dawn. Little foxy thing. Enjoy.
Hi, you're listening to Hollywood Connections with Dawn Reese, and I'm Kathleen Gatti from General Hospital, Dr. Liesl Obrecht.
Hello, I'm Butch Patrick, and you're listening to Dawn Reese's Tan Talk Radio, Hollywood Connections.
John Schneider, you're listening to Dawn Reese on Hollywood Connections.
Listening to Hollywood Connections, I'm Kirstie Alley.
You are listening to Hollywood Connections with Dawn.
And this is Kelly Preston. I'm so excited.
Welcome to Hollywood. What's your dream? Everybody comes here. This is Hollywood, land of dreams. Some dreams come true, some don't. But keep on dreaming. This is Hollywood. Always time to dream, so keep on dreaming.
Hi, welcome to Hollywood Connections, 106.1 FM, The Heat, drive time home. Be careful, it's raining out there. And my co-host,
Lisa V. That's really unattractive out there, to say the least.
I know, and chilly and cold. And yeah. I'm so excited because I have a VIP guest on the phone, but I want to introduce to my right, you are an amazing comic.
Juanita Lolita.
Oh, stay tuned. You're going to have to see her performing at the National Comedy Hall of Fame in soon, this weekend.
This weekend.
Yes, I'll be there. Yes, yes. But in the meantime, why are you tuning into Hollywood Connections? Because we have a hot connection on the line right now. And welcome to Hollywood Connections. You're live. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. I so want to thank you for putting some information on my pageant news and talking about some of the major things that you're doing. And where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Los Angeles.
Yay. That's what this phone call is all about, to get you connected in show business. And tell everybody your name.
So my name is Nyla, kind of like the Nile River, Nyla. And full name Nyla Drani, and I'm a casting producer here in the Los Angeles area and associate producer with a bunch of different reality-based or competition-based shows.
Super cool. I know you're working on some amazing new shows coming up. Can you talk about it on the air and where they can write you?
Yeah, so if anybody ever wants to get in contact with me, the best thing to do is email me. My first name is my starting on my email address. It's N like Nancy, A, E like Edward, L like Larry, A, the word casting, the word production at gmail.com. So fully it's nylacastingproduction at gmail.com.
Oh my gosh, you're like a documentary. I so want to do more of an interview with you. Can you give us a little hint of some of the castings you're working on?
Yeah, so right now I'm just finishing up on America's Got Talent. We actually are starting to film going forward. So casting is ending this week, unfortunately. But if anybody ever wants to get in contact with me, you know, I'll definitely be on the show for next season. So definitely hit me up, because you'll have 6 months to prepare for the casting. And I cast everything from singers, dancers, jugglers, ventriloquists, dance groups, magicians, you name it. I cast for all of the categories. But right now I'm also helping recruit for a big show coming out right now. It's going to be hosted by Ken John. Variety.com just put a huge article out about it. So if you want to look it up, just go to Variety.com, look up Ken John's new show. But basically it's a show where it's brought to you by the executive producers of The Masked Singer. And basically there is going to be a celebrity on the show, and he's going to be, or she's going to be shown a group of strangers. And some of those strangers are amazing singers. Some are completely tone deaf. And the celebrities.
Tone deaf. I like totally tone deaf. What was the guy on American Idol, the Wong guy that
William
I think.
Hung.
Thank you. There you go.
Yeah. I keep telling everybody, channel your William Hung.
Yes, William Hung.
Just channel him. But basically, they're going, the celebrity is the person who's playing the game. Ken Jeong's the one who's hosting the show. And then there's a celebrity panel there just for comedic commentary, essentially. But the celebrity has to figure out, without ever hearing their voices, who are the good singers and who are the bad singers. And they weed them off one by one by one. And the last person standing closes the show with the celebrity. And it could be an amazing, like, Susan Boyle duet moment with that musical celebrity. It could be a William Hung moment with that musical celebrity. And they have to do the whole show, like the whole song, I mean, and end the show with that. So it's going to be an amazing moment. But I'm looking for amazing singers and also those tone deaf ones who, I've been hitting up karaoke places, people who just are like, I don't care what I sound like, I'm having fun.
Right.
You know, so, but they have to really be tone deaf. Not in the middle. A lot of people keep auditioning, and I'm like, well, I sing like you, you know. I'm not Whitney Houston, but I'm not William Hung. I'm looking for a Whitney Houston or a William Hung. It can't be in the middle.
Right. It could be me. When I see even God, is like, what is that noise, woman? You need to stop.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah, that's not what I'm looking for. You can audition that.
Oh, they're both going to audition. They're excited. Yes. And then also, can I say something? Are you doing anything with pageants?
So I'm always looking right now. I'm currently looking for pageant people or people with talents in the pageant world for America's Got Talent. So we, like I said, we're in the last like day or so of casting, and we start filming in the month of March. I'm always looking in the pageant world because I have definitely, I found Darcy Lynn. And she was the little ventriloquist who won the show a couple of years ago, and she was part of the pageant world. So I know that there are amazingly talented people inside the pageant world, both singing, dancing, ventriloquism. And so I'm looking in the pageant world for those strong talents. And just in case I find a diamond in the rough, I'd love to show them to producers here at AGT.
Wow, you have just conquered the right channel because, you know, I'm a national pageant judge. And I have been judging for over 40 years and wrote for Pageantry Magazine. And so, and then I have pageant news. And that's how I found you as well. But, you know, also I want to thank America's Got Talent because a lot of my beauty queen reporters have been actually behind the scenes. And you guys have been wonderful walking them behind the scenes and right up in front and just have just carte blanche us from Hollywood Connections. So we want to thank you for that.
Oh, well, it wasn't me, but I'll take the thing.
I know.
But now it's going to be because I have a crown, I have a title,
Miss Latina.
And I also sing. I'm Miss Latina International Reporter 2020.
There you go. And you do karaoke.
And I sing, I do karaoke, and I se habla español, and I can pretty much do it all. And I'm like a comedian too. My life is hysterical, trust me. God will prove it.
And we've got Juanita Lolita here.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Can't sing. I'll try.
Give her. Well, we're going to send her.
And that's the best. You know, comedians are the best people to audition for this show, for the new one that I'm casting for Ken Jeong's show, because they, no offense, like they're not taking themselves too seriously up there. They're up there and they're having fun. They have the best stage presence and they know how to play into it, you know. So definitely looking for comedians for that one as well. I've had so many reach out to me. And I actually attend about 13 comedy festivals a year nationwide.
Wow.
I just got back from Sioux Falls, South Dakota for the Snow Jam Comedy Festival. And I went to Big Pine Comedy Festival and Big Sky. And I had to unfortunately turn down Just for Laughs. And
You had to turn down Just for Laughs. Wow.
Well, if you ever...
Well, I'm also pregnant, so I can't travel anymore.
Oh, congratulations.
I'll help you.
Yeah, we'll help you.
We'll
stand in for you. We're like, hi, standing in for, it's Lisa Mia and Dawn Reese.
I wish I could go to Laughing Skull. Unfortunately, I can't, but there's a lot of good festivals and a lot of good comedians out there for sure.
Well, it's so exciting to have you, call in and talk about what you're doing. And we've been social media and I'm putting a lot of other pageant directors sending over, like Terry from the World's Tourism Pageant. She just posted it up today as well. So you're going to be getting a lot of people saying, Dawn, Hollywood Connection sent me over. So that's super cool.
Amazing.
Yes.
And go ahead.
Oh, no, I want to, anytime you have something, you're part of the show. You got to call in.
Oh, amazing.
Yes.
Thank you.
And
I'm also looking for previous pageant queens. Weirdly enough, another show I'm casting for, I'm casting three right now, or helping with three essentially. There's another show coming out for a major network, and it's Emmy-nominated casting company called The Casting Firm. But they're looking for vivacious single women in their late 60s, 70s, and 80s who want to go on an adventure of a lifetime.
Oh, wait. Did you say it? Oh, I forgot, because I am that kind of age group.
But you're not single. And I'm
49. No, you have to be single.
49.
You have to be single.
Yeah, she just said single.
This is the first time in history that we've ever been sad to be too young. Ain't that right?
Well, she always pegs me as, you know, 55, 58. She's like, oh, you know, I'm like, no, I'm not your age, Dawn.
Yeah. Our anniversary is tomorrow. So that skips
happy
that one.
Anniversary.
Yes,
happy
thank you.
Anniversary.
Thank you.
I don't know how much does it pay. It might be worth getting a divorce. You never know.
No, we're happily married. We love the sale and we're super excited. No, I'm so excited that you called in. And anytime, please let me know what's happening and we'll put you on the air.
Okay, awesome. It was so nice of you to let me come on.
Yes, we'll send you the clip after we're done.
Okay, great. Thanks so much, ladies.
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
So what do you think of that? You came here, you're a comedian.
I tell you, God is crazy. He's just crazy cool.
I know, isn't that fun?
I have had so many people tell me, you have to be on America's Got Talent. You just have to try. You have to try. And I walk in, you hand me the phone and talking to this lady. I have no idea that she's on America's Got Talent.
Surprise. Okay, so we have a VIP guest on the phone. Tommy, who's on the phone with us?
Another VIP.
It's going to be Kelsey.
Okay, let me before I introduce Kelsey. Hi, Kelsey. I'm so proud of you. But before I go, can we just play that audition on something? You're going to know. This is our mystery guest from Creed Warner. And I just want to play a little bit of her music. And then we're going to come back and we're going to play her other music. We're going to talk to her first. But Kelsey, hold on the line. And this is our mystery guest. And we'll be right back.
He said the way my blue eyes shine put those Georgia stars to shame that night. I said that's a lie. Just a boy in a Chevy truck that had a tendency of getting stuck on back roads at night. And I was right there beside him all summer long. And then the time we woke up to find that summer gone. But when you think Tim McGraw, I hope you make my favorite song, the one we danced to all night long. The moon like a spotlight on the lake. When you think Tim McGraw, hope you think of me.
And we're back, and I'm just getting the chills, and I'll tell you, it's warm in here, but I'm getting the chills, I'll tell you. Right. Kelsey May, welcome to Hollywood Connections. Are you there?
Hi, nice to be here.
Oh, we're so excited. Oh my gosh. You know, a little bit about you. You were on The Voice.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, I was. Oh my gosh, listening back to that. That was singing literally took me back. Oh my goodness. I just turned 21 and I just turned 16 there. So, oh my gosh. Wow.
And so much, has happened. I'm just looking at your bio, singer, songwriter. You're from what city?
Season 8. Oh, well, she was on season 8.
Louisville, Kentucky. Yeah. Really small town. Love it here though.
Okay, it's just destined to stardom, you know, your deep desire to, you know, make a difference in the music industry, your faith. Well, you also have, you know, country music artists. You've been opening up for Sarah Evans, Travis Tritt, Pam Tillis, John Michael. Wow, Montgomery, you know, Mary Stewart, Jewel. You've opened up for all these people.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, it's been a crazy journey. Yeah, I mean, most kids don't decide what they want to do in the eighth grade and follow it from there. But I was one of those that dropped out of school, started singing, landed on The Voice, signed a record deal, and kind of went at it. I mean, as soon as I decided this is what I wanted to do. So definitely taken me, it's taken me a long time to get necessarily where I want in music. But I'm really thankful for the journey so far, for sure.
Wow. I just have a question because we're going to play your new music. How did you meet Creed Warner?
I actually met Creed through Antoine, who you're going to hear from a little bit later, who
who I did the storm with. So he's a great, great person. Love him so much. We just instantly connected. You know, when you meet those people that you don't know from Adam, and then you just kind of instantly connect with them. That was kind of how my relationship with Creed started. So he's fantastic. And yeah, I love what he's done with our song, The Storm. Just an incredible guy for sure.
Amazing. Tell us about the song that we're going to play right now. Did you produce that with what producer?
The Storm? Which song is it that you're about to play?
The Storm?
The Storm. Yeah. So Creed actually produced that song for me and my friend Antoine. And it was a co-written song. Me and Antoine both wrote it. And Creed just did magic with it. So we're so happy to have him on this project. And he did a great job with it.
Wow. I know that you're a busy lady, and we're going to do more of a documentary on you in the future as well. And stay tuned, because we all also have Bonita Lolita comedian here we're going to come back to. But let's go to that song, The Storm, that Creed Broder. He's also a record label producer, and he'll be calling in for a short bit as well. We'll be right back. I am Dawn Rees.
And I'm
Lisa B.
There's always somebody who really wants to make you fall, but you can't rise above it all. Don't listen to the lies that try to make you feel so small, cause you're a hurricane and you're riding through the storm. I went my own way, yeah. Was driven by the wind, I looked for everything, but couldn't find a friend. I felt alone in a crowded room, never had a space to bloom. You took me broken and made me new. Oh God, I owe it all to you. There's always somebody who really wants to make you fall, but you can't rise above it all.
Glad I made it through the stormy weather. I even faced some hurricanes, but now I feel better. I gotta beat the light and darkness like a trendsetter. I'm undefeated on the mic with Kelsey Mayweather. I'm so thankful for the cross, he made my ways better. Now I'm doing up in Christ when they thought I'd never get right back up out there. I follow me and God, I tell you, he put my pieces back together. I'm soaring when I spread my feathers. He picks me up when I'm falling. He's always there when I'm calling. And when I'm feeling, they don't know me by my side when I'm crawling. You give me strength inside the darkness when you shine your light. You fight my battles like I'm boxing in a fixed fight. Because of you, Lord, I never had to be alone. I worship you forever, bow my knees upon your throne. During the times that I was feeling weak, he made me strong. You gave me all the strength I needed just
There's
to make it home.
Somebody
yeah.
really wants to make you fall, but you can't rise above it all. Don't listen to the lies that try to make you feel so small, cause you're a hurricane and you're riding through the storm, riding through the storm. My ship may sink, but my trust is in you. You're the wind in my sails, and you'll carry me through. The waters rage when I'm lost at sea, but by grace, through faith, your love will find me.
Lord, I'm down upon my knees to take this pain away, cause I'm so broken that I can't survive another day. I'm so indebted by my sin, how can I repay? Lord, I'd do anything you want just to make it okay. My back's against the wall, I'm running out of words to say. Then I remember mama always taught me how to pray. Yes, you can move any mountain standing in your way. Just look your problems in the eyes and tell the
There's
devil not today.
There's somebody yeah. who really wants to make you fall, but you can rise above it all.
Riding through the storm.
Yeah, we riding through the storm. Everybody shine your light because we go on this alone. We're coming by his blood, can't nobody bring you on. We are more than overcomers because of what that is for.
And that is called The Storm with Kelsey May. And Kelsey, thank you so much. We're excited. We're going to have you call back in another week or so and do more of an in-depth interview with you and what you've been up to as well. How's that?
That sounds amazing. Thank you so much for having me on. I really appreciate it.
Oh, I heard that you have millions and millions of followers. I have to ask you, how many followers do you have on your social media? Someone just told me. Millions.
Well, I do have quite a few. If anybody wants to check me out online, it's just under Kelsey May Music. But I have about 200,000 on Facebook alone. So definitely have a huge following, and I definitely would not be here if it weren't for my fans. They supported me, like I said, since I was 13. So yeah, I'm just super thankful for them and everything that they've done for me over the past
Kelsey,
years.
I tell you, I'm a Christian comedian. My name is Juanita Lolita. And if you ever want to look me up and share me on your social media, I'd be forever eternally grateful. I swear, I will like clean your toilets in heaven, girl, if you will just do that for me. Juanita Lolita. Yes. Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit put that on your heart.
He did.
Holy Spirit.
Yeah. And make sure you share the show. That would help.
Yeah. I perform comedy in the comedy clubs across the country to give glory to God, and I call it Stand Up For Him. So that would be lovely if you'd like to check out my stuff. That'd be amazing.
Wow, that's amazing.
It's cool. You never know what God's going to do in your life, right,
you
Kelsey?
More people like you.
I'm sorry?
Yes, absolutely. Go ahead.
No, that you just never know where God's going to lead you. And, you know, I feel like the feather in Forrest Gump. I'm just floating, and he's taking me in all these directions I never would have thought of.
That's one of the best parts of the movie.
Yeah.
Yep. I agree. And that's what this show is about. We're bringing more of God to the airwaves of the well, because, you know, this world, there's so many crazinesses going on. I mean, so much happening. And, you know, we just have to keep our eyes on him and focused on him. And that's why I'm trying to bring more lighthearted, more comedy Christian, you know, performers here like yourself, Juanita.
Thank you.
Which is amazing. Well, Kelsey, thank you
absolutely
so much. And I know Creed's going to call in shortly, and I just want to thank you and your song. We're going to play more of your music. We're so excited to have you call in. Thank you.
Thank you. Also, I just want to say that my friend Antoine, who performed that song with me, is on the line too. If you want to reach out to him. So he's also really, really incredible. We co-wrote the song together. So
is he on the phone with you on your phone?
As am I.
Yeah, I'm on here. I was just waiting for my turn.
I was waiting for the phone to flash.
Yeah, we thought you were going to call it. We didn't realize we had two for the price.
Well, yeah, I like that. Yeah, so, nice. So Lisa, read a little bit about him.
As you put out releasing your latest album, 413, All Through Christ, you had 6 nominations and won 2018 Alternative Christian Rap CD of the Year. Wow.
Wow.
And you're the main artist of the song. Mm-hmm. And that's amazing because Creed's texting me, make sure you're getting him on the line. I'm like, he's on the line, Creed.
Yes.
That's so cool. Yeah. Give your social media as well.
Yeah, my Facebook, most of my social media is acforjc.com or acforjc_music on Instagram, acforjc on Twitter. You can find me anywhere with acforjc.
Perfect.
JC stands for Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And we need more of that music. Are you going to be doing more music? You know, do you have more music and more songs? It's all on there, correct?
Yes. Yes, I am currently working on an album, and this current song, The Storm, is going to be on that album. Also, we are currently working on a music video for this song, and praying that gets out within, hopefully, by the end of next month.
Wow.
But it's going to be powerful, and I wish I could tell the details now, but I like to leave people hanging.
I know. How did you meet Creed Warner? Amazing man. That's Christmas music and
funny story. my wife actually met him through a coffee shop, and she was talking to the owner of the coffee shop, and they heard, you know, talking about music, and then I think it was Priest's wife was in there and said, hey, you need to meet my husband. You know, he just moved to the area. And I think you all, you know, would jive together. And then, you know, they put us in contact with each other, and it just happened, you know. It was like a chemistry right off the bat. And Creed was like, man, he's like, you know, you got potential to do this and this and that. And I was like, yeah, you know, I just need a little, you know, boost. And, you know, he sparked it in me to keep going forward with my music, because I was on the verge of giving up on everything. But
And how old are you?
I just turned 35, actually.
Oh, you're so young.
Yes. Last month.
My son told me Kentucky Fried made it when he was 69, 68, something like that.
Yeah. Colonel Sanders.
So you're good. Fried. You're Colonel good Sanders, to go. Yeah. Colonel
Sanders. But yeah, I just turned 35. But, you know, I've been through so much because, you know, I was in the military, and I've had three back surgeries because of an injury that I sustained while in the military. And, you know, going through depression, you know, I'm human, so I went through a little depression.
Amen.
And, you know, God, you know, brought me out of that. And here I am, and I'm still, you know, making music. And every time I do a song, you know, people tell me all the time how inspired they are from the message. And that's what keeps me going, is people telling me that my songs matter.
That it does. And I'll tell you, we just want to thank you so much. And Creed Warner, and he's going to call in for a short minute here in about 15 minutes. And I do want to say something real quick. People, you know, they lose somebody, or they're depressed, or they have everything they want and they're depressed. And, you know, there's a little secret. I told a friend the other day in Hawaii, and she was telling me she was depressed. And I said, you know, my mom used to say, if you get up and you put your tennis shoes on, get out and go for a walk and get some fresh air in you, it does make a difference for anyone out there that is going through depression and you can't get out of the house. And that's just a little words of wisdom. And, you know, I have a picture of my mom and me, and she has passed away, but, you know, I have a picture that says, put your tennis shoes on. And what do I do every morning? And I, you know, take my walk. And I'll tell you, it's amazing. And just for the breath of air that you can get out there.
Yeah.
And I want to thank you so much for calling in. We so look forward to hearing some updates on some new music and playing your music on the air very shortly with us.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for having me. This is a great opportunity to be in Florida, but not really, you know.
Wish you were here. Flip-flop weather and rain-coated, you know, flip-flops an hour ago and, you know, tsunami rain, you know, 35 minutes ago.
Yeah, have you been on the radio before?
Yes, I have. Actually, after I won the award, I was able to get on the station and give interviews and just introduce myself to the world, because I've released 5 albums before. My last one was the biggest one that I've put out, and I think this next one is going to be even bigger.
That's right.
Amen.
So.
Amen.
We believe that, because God is his people. He's taking people away. Why are they going so fast? Why are they going way ahead of the
exactly.
line? Because God is opening the doors for people that trust him. And that's our message today. And
absolutely.
I want to thank you both for calling in. We're so excited. We're going to actually have you call back and keep us updated with all of the amazing adventures you're both on. All righty. Thank you so much.
Bye.
God bless
nice
you.
Nice to meet you.
All righty.
Nice to meet you too.
Bye, Kelsey. Bye-bye. Okay, so 106.1 FM, The Heat, and that's what we're doing. We're bringing artists to the air. If you have a song that you want to be played, remember the old times that they used to bring? No, I'm looking at you. Do you sing?
Yeah, that's because she's looking at her face. Is like, did you not just hear me say, I can't sing.
No, I can't sing.
Do you remember when Loretta Lynn and all the stars used to go to all the radio stations
and
play their music?
Yeah, they had to.
And nobody's doing that. But guess what? We are.
We are.
Me and the station owner are doing that. So we are playing your music and bringing it to this airwaves. We got a really great deal. So if you're an artist and you want airplay on 6 stations, 3 FM, 3 AM, there's so much happening here at Tan Talk Radio Network.
Well, besides the Instagram and YouTube live, I mean, you get a lot. I mean, 4 million, you know, the station owner said there's like 4 million.
Exactly.
Wow. So this is the place to go if you want to expose yourself. Yes. That's what you're saying.
Exactly.
I looked at your eyes and I knew you were going there. I was like, she's my kind of peeps.
But they can also watch our show on Tan Talk Radio Network on YouTube and all of the amazing shows that we have and all of our Hollywood connections also. And we are so excited. So welcome, Juanita Lolita. Thank you for your patience.
Oh, no, we're good.
I was a flight attendant.
It's been great. I just heard that.
Where's my coffee?
No worries.
In my car.
It's been great listening to everything going on and
And just all the wonderful things that God does and continues to do. And, you know, no, it's not just me. He does it for, he does what it for made, all these people.
Before I go into your comedy that Tommy has a clip of, what made you get into stand-up comedy?
Somebody signed me up for an open mic at a comedy club.
So you had no comedy classes? You just went?
No. I just went. I was scared to death, actually. It was kind of funny because I was so afraid to even touch the microphone stand that it didn't matter. Whoever was up before me, wherever they left it was where it was. So I either bowed down or stood up on my tiptoes to do my comedy. So it was great. Ended up, there was a competition. I won the competition.
And nice. What did you win for prizes?
It was just moving forward to the next round for Florida's Funniest Person. So that's where I was on my second time ever on stage. It was pretty cool.
So what do you want to do with your career? Where do you see yourself?
Wherever God takes me.
I know.
It's
I love
really,
it.
Yeah. You know, if I were to sit down and plan out, if I would have said 5 years ago that, I mean, I used to mow lawns for a living. That's what I did. I owned my own lawn care business. And when I say owned it, I was the sole owner, proprietor, and lawn person. It was all me.
And mechanic,
everything.
Right?
With the blades. Yes.
You were in construction.
I was.
And that's what I did. And I used God to stock shelves at Publix. And now I travel the country doing comedy in comedy clubs and in corporate events and
Well, when you get to be, you know, in your 50s and you're looking for just a fun job and it's just, you know.
Which I'm not there yet.
A 40s. And they say, can you lift 40 pounds or 30 pounds? You know, there's so many jobs. You know, no, I don't want to lift anymore.
I love your text messages between midnight and 2 when you're on this. She's like, $10 an hour. Forget that. To do that, it's hilarious. It really is.
You got to bed, lift 50 pounds and forget it.
I love it.
So let's go to a comedy clip. What one are we going to play? One of your features. And we're ready. Let's get some comedy drive time.
Yes. I think you picked this one in honor of Dawn's anniversary.
Oh,
right?
Oh, that's right. My anniversary's tomorrow. We're going to play that song for my hubby, too.
All right, cool.
We'll be right back. Let's go to comedy.
Juanita Lolita. You know, it's funny. She couldn't say
bananas, but she got Juanita Lolita.
Oh, okay. Well, what is that?
I'm so excited to be here. I am. And like she says, my name is Juanita Lolita. So I need to know, please, can you say for me, Juanita Lolita? That's very good. And that's a funny name, huh? It's funny to me. You know why?
I don't talk like that.
That's not a real name. Kid you not, y'all. My parents did that to me. That is my first and middle name, Juanita Lolita. My last name growing up, Mills. Juanita Lolita Mills. And I don't know how to speak Spanish at all. And that's crazy because my older sister, she knows how to speak Spanish. But that's because she was born in Miami. But see, I was born in Florida. In the Miami. I got my name because I'm the product of a West Virginia a hillbilly and a New York City Puerto Rican. So I'm a hillbilly Rican. That's kind of a hard marriage there, y'all, but I think all marriages are difficult. You know, I'm married. People change when they get married. They do. Because before we got married, I thought my husband was Superman. I did. There was nothing he couldn't do. Nothing. And I still think he's Superman. I'm just convinced that old wedding band is kryptonite. Because ever since he said I do, he don't no more. You're thinking about that now, aren't you? But I realized, y'all, I changed too. And I always wanted to put a spark in our marriage, right? One of the ladies in my Bible study, she said, oh, you got to do what I did. She went online and got a fishnet bodysuit. I don't think that's going to add a spark to my marriage. I don't think he wants to see a sumo wrestler in a hammock. Do you know what I'm saying? Squish out of those little holes. I'd be like Play-Doh through a cheeseburger, man. The only thing that's going to do is stop him from ever going fishing again. Damn. And then another friend said I should get some Victoria's Secret onions, right? But that place is expensive.
paying $10 for one pair of britches. I go to Walmart and get a six-pack of britches for $10. Of course, now I realize it's because the stitching is irregular. Because the other day, the pair I had on, the elastic that was around this right leg was really, really tight. So by the end of the day, I had lost feeling in this whole leg. So I was kind of having to do this, just trying to get my leg to wake up, right? And then I realized, y'all, that's why the people at Walmart walk like that. You see them pushing their car? I used to think there was something wrong. That's just the cheap undie popping lock there. And then I tried on skinny jeans. That's false advertising. I don't care how many I tried on, I didn't look skinny. I looked like a golf ball on a tee. I'm going to give y'all a minute for that visual. I shouldn't call them skinny jeans. They should be called bakery britches, right? All they do is up a muffin, dog. Do you know the muffin man? Yeah, his name's Levi Strauss. But those skinny jeans are hard to get up, aren't they? I don't think you men realize that's the real reason the two women go to the bathroom together. We're not talking about you. One woman's helping the other to get their pants pulled back. You men use that little loop on the side of your jeans for your belt, don't you? We ladies use that as a hoist, don't we, ladies? Ladies, round of applause if you've ever used this thing to get your britches up. Let me hear you. Yes, you have. Lady, round of applause. You ever broke this thing off? Yes, you have. Every one of my jeans has this thing wasn't even in the window, and I held on as long as I could. Man, that's when the struggle is real right there. Thank you all so much for having me.
The National Comedy Hall of Fame Museum is now open in Tampa Bay. Information on the museum can be found at nchof.com.
Do you want your happy anniversary song coming back here?
The museum just announced the induction class of 2020, which includes legends such as Joan Rivers, Eddie Murphy, Will Ferrell, Dan Aykroyd, and John Cleese. Also on site, there are live comedy classes and stand-up comedy. Information on the comedy classes can be found at hofcomedyschool.com, and the live shows are posted at comedyhof.com. Come out and see us.
Looking to cool off in the summer or turn up the heat in the winter? Then head over to Clearwater Ice Arena, Tampa Bay Skating Academy Oldsmar, or TBSA Countryside. With three locations in the Tampa Bay area, you can enjoy a wide range of hockey and figure skating activities and programs. We offer youth and adult pickup hockey and leagues, skate, shoot, freestyle, and public skating times throughout the day, so you will want to come back again and again. It's fun for the whole family. And don't forget to schedule your next birthday party or private event with us. Visit TampaBayIce.com for more information.
Happy anniversary, baby. Got you on my mind.
There we go.
Keep
Happy
going.
Happy anniversary, baby. Got
for you, bro.
This
is for my husband. Tomorrow's our anniversary.
How long?
Well, we've been together almost 10 years, but 4 years married.
Awesome.
This is for him.
Yes, Bert.
Yes, we are. Yes, my husband that works very hard for us.
And is the sweetest man literally on the face of this earth. He really is. He's the nicest man, always polite, always nice, no matter how tired he is.
Oh, he's...
Oh, yeah. He'll be like, I'm beat, but how are you?
I know. And he's been working, painting houses, and we have a sailboat, so that's what we do. So, honey, this song is for you, really, because we have like a minute. Well, while that's playing... Yeah. So I got to tell you a funny story. So last week I went to the casino to play Keno, right?
Uh-huh.
And just real quick, I look at the guy next to me because I like only 5 cent Keno. And I said, my machine is broke. There's like 20. Why is it doing the 20 max? And I'm getting 20 nickels. And he goes, lady, and I hit it again. I won $100, which was awesome. But I said, because your machine isn't broke, you're playing the max. And but they switched the buttons over. So when you're used to doing the one, and I was like, but
sneaky.
I was like, then I was like, my machine is broke. He's like, no, it's not. You're hitting the maximum.
I love when you're there and the people next to you have been on the machine that you get on, and then I show up and I do the max, and it's like, you know, the 8750, they're like, what? And I'm like, I give half to God, so I guess it helps. So
when Chrissy showed up, showed up, and she was next to me. She's like, well, you can play this forever. I said, yes, on a nickel. You can sit here for 5 hours and play. Yeah, so that was that was fun. So anyways, happy anniversary to my husband. And so there we go. That's for tomorrow. We have dinner and dancing, all that good stuff. So tell me, also, you're going to be performing at a couple places coming up.
I am. I absolutely. Oh, you want me to do this like right now? My phone just shut down. All right.
You're going to be at the National Comedy Hall of Fame.
The National Comedy Hall of Fame, Saturday evening, in 8 p.m.
It's a new comedy museum, which I love over there.
It's 2435 U.S. Highway 19 Holiday. I will be there.
At what time is your show?
Yes. 8 o'clock.
You're welcome. No, yes, yes, no.
Because I was thinking of the other one. You're like, get at your show.
And then you're going to be over in St. Petersburg.
Correct. It's a fundraiser for our Estrie Street Project at Radiant Church, which is on 16513 Street South in St. Pete, and it is at 6:45.
We'll post that out there on social media as well.
I mean, there are so many. I am booked the 1st, the 5th, the 6th, the 7th, the 8th, the 10th, 13th, 14th, 17th, 20th, 21, 20. Yeah. So
Do you need somebody like to hold your bag or open the door for you? I mean, I know if you're booked everywhere, somebody's going to be able to go, who's that lady? I sing. She's the funny one. I'm the singer. She can't sing. That's what's funny.
I don't sing. Yeah, like I said, I sing so bad. God's like, what is that noise, woman? Silent meditation.
Yes. But you know, it's also great. We have an agent that is under our show of Hollywood Connections, a SAG agent. So they gave me all the paperwork for really talented people, and it's not exclusive.
And you haven't given me any yet. I wonder why.
I sent it a couple times.
I know, I'm joking. That's a joke. That's a joke. You have to send me everything three times.
Now she's picking on me. Okay, so in the meantime, I'll send you that as well. So you have
that.
So you have more agents. Mm-hmm. And do you do?
I don't have
booking?
Any agents. Yeah, I do. I do it all.
Wow.
So, Wow. Actually, I don't. God does. Right, I'm kind of answering the phone, okay, I'll be there.
But so you know,
I have an assistant, a friend of mine now, and she helps to answer the phone, and it's just been amazing.
And a lot of film directors and producers and all the people in casting love comics because you're fun to work with, and that makes a huge difference in TV and film.
You know, what's crazy is I never ever thought about doing comedy. I wanted to be an actress. That's what I wanted to be when I was little. So that's just what I wanted to do. And then here I get thrown into comedy, but I was in a movie. So that's coming out. And, you know,
what movie?
Video. I don't know.
It's called I Don't Know What Video.
It's called Always With You, and it's a Christian film. And I was, it's funny because I played this old woman that's dying. So my makeup is absolutely hideous with the under. I'm like, cinematic debut.
Yeah, right.
Awesome.
What to look forward to, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, next year you'll have to submit to the International Christian Film Festival, and you'll have to get out there. And it's over in Orlando, and it's amazing. So many film directors from all over. It's all Christian based. You can even audition with casting directors.
That
Google,
would be amazing.
Yes,
last
international.
Last year was Lou Gossett Jr. was inducted into the Hall of Fame there.
That was pretty neat
to be like,
Kevin
I wanted
Sorbo.
To walk up to him. Yeah, I wanted to walk up to him and go, mayonnaise, you know, because of the way he used to call Officer and a Gentleman. That was what Lou Gossett said to Richard Gere. He called him mayonnaise. His last name was Mayo.
Yeah, and it is.
Yeah. Watch it, really good. Come on, mayonnaise. And that's where their love hate started.
As I remember, the International Christian Film Festival, and they're looking for volunteers. That's coming up in May. And also, we have a Creed Warner. He is on the line with us. Thank you, Creed, for holding. We're going a bit over. And Creed, tell us, you know, you had the artists that were on the phone with us. You helped them with their music and recording. You're also a Christian label. And Lisa's a singer. I know she has questions for you. So welcome to the show.
Do you need any comics?
Hey,
that's
you.
My
thank
question.
You, everybody. Yeah, definitely. You all definitely need to sign up for the comic bit for sure. You all had me rolling while I was on.
None of this
is
planned.
AC, Antoine, and Kelsey May, I had met them. And you know that she was on the Voice a few seasons back. And she's definitely got some fame from that. Well, I had met AC, and he was working on some music, and he was looking at getting some radio airplay and things like that. Well, they had went and had written this song together. And so I invited them to come down and to talk about the song. So I brought them in the studio to record it. Well, a lot of times in the studio, you know, the magic happens in the studio, and it was perfect. It was perfect song to release to radio. So we ended up doing that, and my company. So we released that to the radio promotions company, a nationwide company, and we had success. It took a couple months to get enough radio airplay on it, and it actually landed on the charts last week, and it came in at number 15 on the DRT Top 50 Inspirational Gospel Charts. So I had a feeling, and so did they. They had a feeling that it would definitely be a chart topper. And, you know, when God's in it, you really can't mess up, you know?
Amen.
No. God's timing is always the best.
Yeah, yes. And Creed,
it is.
Yeah, Cree had an amazing studio here. Where are you at, Creed, again? What city?
I'm actually in West Virginia now.
Oh, my family.
I'm in Huntington, West Virginia, which is the home of Marshall University.
I'm all right there. There is my family. I feel like I'm talking to someone alone.
So that's where I'm out of now. And I haven't, I've been working a lot behind the scenes this past year. As you probably know, if you spend any time on Facebook, my wife and I had our first baby.
Yay!
Oh, congratulations.
So I've been off the road a little while, but I really, really enjoy being a dad and spending that time with him.
Wow. I want to do like a Facebook Live with you sometime in the next week and talk about the music industry and how you can help people where they can come over and you can help them record, like Lisa.
Like me.
A trip to West Virginia. There you go.
I'm there.
Hey. Yeah. If you go, I gotta go.
Yep. Next month, it'll start warming up. So next month will be the time to come in. Right now, we're expecting some snow tonight. So you don't want to come right now.
No. That's probably why I do have my relatives, Rod and Melva Adkins, which is half the mailboxes up there is Adkins.
It's either Adkins or a Mullins or, you know,
The
Hatfields or the McCoys.
Exactly. That's all up in that. But they're coming down to visit this week, so that's probably why, because of all the cold.
Oh, absolutely.
It's either the Gomez's or the Rodriguez's or the Diaz's, because I'm from Miami, so, you know.
Like a ping pong ball.
Well, my daddy took me up there, and we're driving through all the mountains, and he said, every Adkins you see, we're related. And I'm like, good Lord, is there any non-Adkins?
That's scary.
Wait, like the Shake Adkins? Like the Lose Weight Adkins?
No, AD.
It's AD.
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 I love those snack bars, by the way.
All the ad or Kins.
They're delicious. The caramel ones, they taste like yummy.
Where did these women get off on that?
I'm hungry.
Don't they know, Creed, that we are West Virginians, and we do not diet? Don't they understand that?
I used to be 315 pounds. I cooked for 11 and ate for 5, I promise.
Well, I know it goes so fast, Creed, and I thank you. You've been about a part of Hollywood Connections for Everland, and you know, I just want to thank, you know, actually our dear friend that introduced me to you, and
I come to Huntington, I'm coming to visit y'all now.
Absolutely. So, you're welcome anytime. But Dawn, thank you so much for having thank you so much for having AC and Kelsey on.
They were such
a
delight.
They do have big plans, and they do have new songs coming out also. Kelsey does a lot of worship music now.
Nice.
And so that's kind of where she's headed and the way and the direction that God has her. And AC's got, he said it just a few minutes ago, he's got some new songs in the works that he's going to be releasing to radio along with Kelsey. Separately.
Well, we definitely
they do have separate careers. They do have separate careers.
Right.
But they did do this duet that just took the industry by a storm, and it's climbing the charts. So we're real happy and real proud of both of them and proud of that project.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. Awesome. And you have another question.
I have a question for you. How hard is it? I mean, right now, I mean, God literally put it on my heart. You know, it's an older song. How hard is it to get permission to redo what was a rock song and make it, you know, Christian lyrics? Like, is it really hard? I mean, where do you start? Because that's something that...
It's still considered a parody, although it may be serious lyrics. Like, if you're taking a song that's already existed, but you're adding you're putting new lyrics to it.
Right. So well, you're just using the, you know, the tracks, right? And then you're putting
correct.
Different
you're
lyrics.
Using a parody. You need to get a parody license.
Okay.
For that, whether the publishing company is interested in for you doing that or not, I'm not sure. It just depends on it. And what you need to reach out for first off is to get a mechanical license. And then I think it's another form that you fill out or a permission that you use for a parody because you're going to be writing different lyrics to it.
Okay.
Good advice.
But it is a little bit tricky, but I think it can be done. But it depends if they're willing to do that or not.
I you know, Googled it, and it's been like four other people have taken this song and redid it for, you know, like praise and worship type music. But like literally sure. as I drive and hear this song a lot because – you know, I'm going through some stuff and it keeps me going. Literally, like, lyrics come to my head and then I start singing them and I'm like, hey, this could work. So,
yeah.
Well, you know, sometimes it's better off to, you've already got basically the format of the song written as far as your new lyrics. Sometimes it's better off is just to put other music with it that fits it, but that you're not stealing or robbing, you know, the original song. But I mean, every song has already been written. Every music pattern has already been played. It just, I mean, if you listen to any modern music that's on the radio, you're hearing the tonic chord, you're hearing the one chord, the five chord, and the six minor chord. You're hearing that over and over and over again. And it's all in all popular music. So it's not hard to reproduce a track that doesn't sound so close to what you're trying to do that parody to.
Right.
So sometimes you go in a studio and just play it a new way, but you're still getting the same feeling out of that song. So that may be something you could think about also.
Awesome. Corinne, I know it's closing time. We have to announce a special a news bulletin on something. But we want to thank you. We're going to have you call in again because people are
sure,
asking
absolutely.
Questions and they want to talk to you live right. on the air. So we're going to bring Corinne back with us again. There's so many questions as a record label, which is so phenomenal.
No problem.
We love you.
Yes,
we miss
you.
And congratulations on the new baby.
And I'm not kidding you. Juanita Lolita is going to come to visit you. So you'll be looking
yes.
for Juanita
right.
Lolita. Okay.
You all have a great evening.
Thank you. Thank you. Warner, and I'll put that information up, Creed Warner. You know, he's over in West Virginia,
Huntington.
Right. I have 2 minutes. Let's go to that breaking news little note that I gave. And while we're doing that, I just want to let everyone know there is a beauty queen reporter that I had, and she was kind of part-time with me. Her name is Lisa Todd, age 16, from Austin, Texas. She's missing and endangered. They just put this on the Facebook, and I've been sharing it. And Lisa Todd is 16, was last seen February 25th in Austin, Texas. She is 5'7", weighs 130 pounds, and has hazel eyes, brown hair. If you have any information, please call the Travis County Sheriff. Oops, so here we go. 512-854-9721, and I have information up there as well. And yes, what?
He was pointing at you.
Oh, hi. He's telling me 2 minutes.
Yeah, said 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Yeah.
And our prayers are for her family, and she has been actually a beauty queen of many titles and a top reporter for me as well. And funny, funny gal. We just put her in our prayers. But anyways, for that. Juanita, thank you for being here. Did you have fun?
I did. I went too fast. We need to do it again.
We need more sponsors. Help us. Help us stay on the air. Let's get every hour booked. Call me at 727-871-7788. By the way, I have a digital business card. It's phenomenal. You have one too.
I do. It's amazing.
We will text you the digital business card if you say digital business card. Again, 727-871-7788. And also, Lisa, we're looking for beauty queen reporters, more reporters on the red carpet. We have sunscreen. We have Gasparilla. We have International Christian Film Festival. A lot is happening in the next 2 months. It will be on the red carpet.
Yes.
And also Tampa Bay Film Society, you need to get in touch with me if you want to be. I'm on the board. And also Women in Film with Bobby Hill once a month and network with film directors and casting directors. Okay, I think I said it all. Anything else, Lisa?
I think we got it all. Now, we got like 30 seconds, but I was lucky to be what I thought was a non-speaking extra in The Last Bounty, but it's sort of comical because it's just like, uh-oh. You know, I show up and I got to talk, which is really great. So thank you, Anthony, for allowing me to be part of your dream
see you in the movies.
Yes, we'll see you in the movies.
And if you want to be discovered, this is the show. We may put you on. We are going to be looking for more singers, actors, models, and we have reporters auditioning live if you'd like
comedians.
To be one.
Comedians.
And comedians. And look out for Juanita Lolita. Bye, everybody. God bless. Bye. Remember, give God all the glory and honor in your life. Watch WTAM, things happen.
FM 106.1.
WDCF, Dig City.
FM
102.3. WZHR, Zephyr Hills.
FM 104.3.
Listen.
Milwaukee shooting fatalities, coronavirus addressed. I'm Barbara Cusack. Response teams from the Milwaukee Police and other law enforcement agencies converged on the Molson Coors Brewing Company campus amid reports of a shooting. Correspondent Bryn Gingras tells us.
There is just a large federal and local police presence there. We know the ATF responded, the FBI, and of course, Milwaukee Police.